James Lahey, and I'm an artist, and I live in Toronto. I'm primarily known for painting. The only thing I really ever wanted to do was to make pictures for a living, but I really didn't think that you could do that. I'll tell you the story. But I remember it quite vividly. I was a young guy, and my mom and I had gone out to the National Gallery in Ottawa. I was probably maybe seven or something like that. And we were touring, sort of walking through the galleries, and she said, "And that man there is the artist." And I was bowled over by this, because he was a man like my father. Like, he was like a grown man, and he was the artist. And in my child's mind, I kind of thought artists all died in Italy like 300 years ago. And I looked at my mother and I said, "You mean you can make pictures all your life?" And she said, "Yeah, then you'd be an artist." I said, "Well, then that's what I'm gonna do." Graduated in 84, and I started showing in third year. And I always did exhibitions. You know, we didn't sort of pursue commercial relationships right after school. It was sort of, you know, you do shows with your friends, you rent spaces, you do these impromptu things, you know. And I kept doing that for a long time. My first commercial relationship I got when I was 30, I guess, or 20, yeah, 30. A woman by the name of Fella Grunwald, she had a partner, Linda Genereux. By the end of 1997, I had a bit of a bankroll. I also had a 12-year-old daughter at that point, and so at the end of 97, I made that leap to just go at it full time. And I had a number of dealers in the U.S. and a few in Canada. So all my work is autobiographical, all of it. It's all really connected to moments in my life, and those are the sources that I use for everything. So, you know, when I started painting flowers, it wasn't about wanting to paint flowers. It was about dealing with a kind of long conversation that I wanted to have with my father, who had passed away. And that was a way of continuing to talk to him. The skull pieces that I started in, I started to show in 2006 or 2007, were connected to when my dad passed away. My mother gave me a little panel that my father had painted when he was about seven or eight, and it was on his tree fort, and it said, it had a skull and crossbones, and it said, "Keep out." So I had that all restored and cleaned and framed, and I'd been looking at it for about 7 years or so at the entranceway to my studio every day, you know, and it was something he made as a kid. He kept it in his sock drawer his whole life. Anyway, I really just wanted to enter a conversation that many artists have entered, which is dealing with, you know, death, and using the skull as a metaphor for that conversation. Just make my contribution. But it was connected to events in my own life. And I think that's the only way I know how to do anything. They somehow have to come, they somehow have to be connected to people that I love or events in my life. You know, they have to, the work's all in the end personal. But I think at the time, anything that leaves here, at the time I would have believed I gave it everything I could, or wouldn't have left the studio. That doesn't mean I might not look at a piece that I made a few years ago and think, oh, you know, that happens. Absolutely. But at the time, I really do try to ensure that when anything leaves here, it's had, you know, I've given it all I possibly can. That I, you know, nothing ever feels finished entirely to me, ever. That is a very hard part of this. But, you know, you gotta live and eat and all the rest of it. But I really do, that's important to me. And I hope that the people that live with the work realize that I threw myself into the work entirely. On the mountain, come on.